Hey friends, on an earlier episode, we took a look at Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes with GitOps. Now, Thomas Maurer is here to show me how you can manage, tag, and configure Kubernetes clusters running outside of Azure, all from the Azure portal. We'll also take a look at some hybrid solutions in the Azure Architecture Center today on Azure Friday. Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Thomas and some more exciting Azure Arc content. How are you, sir?
Doing great, Mr. Hanselman. Doing great.
All right. So last time we did some cool stuff with Azure GitOps, and we learned about managing Kubernetes. Now we're going to go kind of to the next level and learn more about how to manage and tag and configure stuff. And you brought me some wonderful demos.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, we realize that a lot of customers are running in hybrid environments, right? Mm-hmm. And they are not just going away. So we're definitely going to talk about how we can take complexity of that away. Because what we saw is that a lot of customers are managing hundreds or even thousands of different applications. And some of them are very modern applications running on PaaS services, .NET Core, or Kubernetes. But there are also a lot of traditional applications. And IT needs to manage all of that, right? And making it even worse, there is a lot of diverse infrastructure in a lot of IT departments, from running services in their own data centers, running their own applications, until they go up to the edge, where they probably deploy stuff in factories or retail stores. And also, a big part of it can run in multi-cloud environments, right? So IT, again, and developers need to manage and deploy on all of these infrastructures and different application types. So we want to make that easier with our hybrid cloud offering.
Right. And this doesn't just integrate them on like on the monitor screen or just in the portal. It's fundamentally at the control plane level. So you're able to manage all these environments with the same APIs, with the same ARM templates, with the same portal.
Absolutely. So let me show you what we have. We have a couple of solutions there. So I'm going to quickly share my screen here. And if we look at our hybrid portfolio here, what we're trying to do, as you said, we're going to use Azure as a control plane. It's not just something, as you said, like services showing up in the Azure portal. It's really at the fundamental layer. So you can also use ARM templates and PowerShell and the CLI to manage all of that using the control plane. Then we also offer to deploy services and bring services at your location, right? We heard from many, many customers that they actually want to have Azure SQL, for example, that they love it, but they cannot run it for every workload in an Azure region, like data sovereignty challenges or network latency challenges. So what we did is with Azure Arc, we allow them to bring Azure services to their specific location. Then we also offer our Azure Stack portfolio, which allows us to bring basically infrastructure into the customer locations. And then obviously we also have a very large set of IoT solutions out there for these modern workloads as well.
Very cool.
So what I want to show you is, now the question often comes up is, how do I actually implement all these cool solutions, right? Okay, we have solutions for this, but where can I find how to implement and architect the solution? So we worked on creating some hybrid solution architectures, which you can find in the Azure Architecture Center. So if you go to the Azure Documentations page, you can find a section called Architectures. And if you have a closer look at this, you get some more information, but you can then also browse all the different architectures here. And these are general architectures for Azure solutions. But if you scroll down a little bit, you can also find the different categories here. And we have one for hybrid and multi-cloud scenarios. So if I select this, we get this filter over it. And you can see here, we have a ton of different hybrid architecture solutions now. And since a lot of customers are going and working on Kubernetes, as you mentioned before, we also have one for that. So if I look here for Kubernetes, I can then find our architecture here for hybrid management and deployment for Kubernetes clusters. So as you can see here, you find obviously a nice diagram, and I'm going to show you how that looks like in the portal as well. But then you get also some additional information here, how that actually is deployed, what you can do, what the additional benefits are of that, and so on. Now, I already deployed this in the portal. I already connected Kubernetes clusters to my Azure environment. And to find out more, I just go to the Azure Arc section here. This is basically the central place to go for resources which are connected from outside of Azure. You actually can bring that into the Azure Arc Center. And here you can, again, get some information how you get started. You can see here, for example, how you can connect different services or how you can actually deploy other stuff, right? You can see here that I can connect servers, SQL servers, and much, much more. But what I want to show you is the Kubernetes cluster connection. So what you can see here, I have two Kubernetes clusters here. I click on this one, for example. This one runs outside of Azure in my local data center. Basically, to be fair, it runs underneath my desk right now, right? So as you can see here first, it looks like an Azure resource, right? I get an overview, I get some information, it's part of a resource group. It really looks like it's running in Azure. However, it's really actually not, right? I get some interesting monitoring solutions. So I can go to Insights and find how is my Kubernetes cluster doing. I can see some CPU utilization of the cluster itself. You can see here, my cluster is not doing that much, to be fair. But you can see here some nice additional information about the different nodes and everything which is running there. I can also have more reports. I can see the different nodes I have. I can go into some more, get some more details on the controllers, or then, for example, on what containers am I running on this specific cluster. However, there is more. Obviously, managing a cluster like this is one thing, right? I can see it now, I can see it's working. But what I also want to do is actually deploy applications on it. So for that, we are using something called GitOps. And I already deployed an application on it. I already did a configuration. So what I said basically here, if we look at that configuration, and I'm sure we have that seen before, this is actually going out and pulling my application from a Git repository. And it does that like right now every 3 seconds, which is probably a little bit aggressive, but it's good to show that in a demo, right? So this is my Git repository, as you can see. I have a sample application here, if we look at that. And I deployed that application with that configuration. And the deployed application looks exactly like that, right? So it's a demo application. So what I'm actually want to do is, I want to obviously not say hello Azure Arc, I want to say hello Azure Friday. So since I'm an ops person and I love doing things in production, I'm just going to do something which people probably shouldn't do at home. Just going to quickly change it here in the main branch. I scroll down, I'm going to change the messaging here. Hello, Azure.
Someone at Stack Overflow called that Hanselmaning into production one time.
Yeah, okay. So I Hanselmaning into production and just do a commit here directly.
Okay.
Which, again, probably not a good idea to do at home, but that's what it is. So what now will happen is, if we go back to that configuration, we will see that this now has the configuration and configured my Kubernetes cluster to pull that repository for changes every 3 seconds. And if we now go back to the application, we can just do a refresh here. And we can see here, it says, hello, Azure Friday.
Wow, that was really fast. How did that happen so fast? Now, certainly I understand that the polling was set high for the purposes of the demo. You might set it for 15 minutes or an hour or whatever for production.
Absolutely. Yeah, you would definitely not need that fat to be that fast in production, right? In many cases. However, the real power now comes with obviously doing that not just for one cluster, but doing that for several clusters, right? So if I have one cluster, that's probably an easy thing to do. You could say, Thomas, why didn't you do that manually? It's probably as fast as possible. But if you need to do that for 100 clusters, the story is a little bit different. And what we can leverage here is we can use something like we have in Azure for a while. It's called Azure Policy. And Azure Policy allows me to configure my Kubernetes clusters for security and make sure that everything is configured in a compliant way. But I can also configure the app deployment directly from Azure Policies. So as soon as I join a new Kubernetes cluster to my environment, it will automatically deploy that application to that Kubernetes cluster.
Wow. And this is really under your desk. This is an Azure managed resource. All Azure Arc magic happens, and it's in your office. It's on premises.
Exactly. It's wherever I want it to be, right? I could also set it up somewhere in my branch offices. I have so many branch offices, or my factories, or even at another cloud provider, right? So I could manage Kubernetes clusters which run somewhere else.
Did you have to set it up ahead of time, or could it be existing and then you enable it, you Azure Arc enable it?
Yes, you're absolutely right. So it's not something which I need to deploy in one direction. I can really just take an existing Kubernetes clusters, an existing Kubernetes cluster, and join it to Azure using Azure Arc. And obviously, we're not just to, it doesn't need to be running, for example, on Azure Stack HCI. It can, absolutely. We have some great solutions there, which we talk about a little bit in a bit. But it can be anything. It can be OpenShift. It can be your version of Kubernetes you're using.
That's cool. I need to go and take my tiny Kubernetes stack, my Raspberry Pi Kubernetes, and Azure Arc enable it someday.
Absolutely. So the next thing we should talk about is databases, right? I mean, this is one thing to have actually these applications. But the other thing is what we need to have is databases. So Azure Arc also allows me to actually deploy our SQL, Azure SQL managed instance offering on my infrastructure of choice, right? We heard that from many, many customers. They said, hey, look, it's great. We love it. But we want to use it in our own data centers or in our factory, which does not really have a good internet connectivity. And we cannot really rely on that. So we want to deploy it directly there. And that is also something I did here underneath my desk. I was deploying that. So I already deployed the Azure Data Services, the managed SQL. And I opened up here Azure Data Studio, which allows me to manage different database offerings we have. So you can see here, I could manage my regular Azure databases and so on. However, what I did here is you can see here, I already have my Azure Arc controller here, and I created a instance here. And I can also find some more information on this specific instance. So you can see here, this is running locally in my location here. I can then do get the connection strings, or what our people love, instead of just connecting a SQL server, we can actually use the scaling as we can do in Azure, right? So we can add more CPU to that instance, more memory to it, and so on. So we can really manage that as we could do, basically manage that instance in Azure.
How is that possible, though, if it's a local resource?
Yeah, so what actually happened is we have a Kubernetes cluster, mm-hmm. and then we deploy the Azure data source, the Azure data services on top of that. So nice. We have built, or the team has built, a containerized solution to build that on top of it. So the only thing you need, wherever you want to deploy it, is a Kubernetes cluster, and you can go out and deploy that.
That's cool. That's a lot easier than editing YAML.
Absolutely. So many of our customers obviously also ask us about infrastructure, right? All the things I just showed you with Azure Arc doesn't need any Microsoft infrastructure. It can run on your existing virtualization solutions you have in place, or your physical machines, or again, other cloud providers as well, even though probably Azure is the best choice. If you still need infrastructure, and many of you want infrastructure, we have our Azure Stack portfolio, right? And it's not just a single product anymore, as it used to be. It's now a family of products. And we offer you, for example, Azure Stack Hub, which allows you to get this consistent experience with Azure, this cloud-native experience in connected and disconnected environments. We offer you Azure Stack Edge, which is basically a first-party appliance to run your machine learning solutions at the edge, and is also kind of like a gateway to transfer your data. And then obviously the last part being Azure Stack HCI, which is our new hyper-converged solutions for virtualization workloads. On that, you can also run our AKS service, which we have in Azure. And so you can bring AKS, the managed service, into your data center, directly running on your own hardware.
I love this stuff. I've talked about Azure Stack Edge, and we had folks on before, and we talked about it at Ignite in the keynote. I actually got to have one in my desk, and they're truly amazing.
Yeah, absolutely. I wish they would send me one, but unfortunately, it's a little bit, I cannot really have it here. It's a little bit too loud to record videos with something like that underneath your desk. Yeah, but again, these are great solutions. And again, they scale. For example, if you look at Azure Stack HCI, we see them deploying in very, very small scale from two node clusters for your branch offices or factories up to very large scale solutions in your data centers, right? Where you need the fastest storage performance or where you need a very high capacity on storage. So again, really have different solutions depending on your needs. And so if people want to know more and learn more about this, they can actually go to the Azure Architecture Center and find more about these different architectures and can actually go and browse in and can see how they actually can build these in their own environment.
Fantastic. This sounds really exciting. So folks should go ahead and take a look at the previous episodes that we've done as well and go and learn all about this great stuff. Hybrid solutions. The Architecture Center is really deep. It's almost like a kind of an infinite book. It starts with those diagrams and it starts digging into exactly what you need to do. So hopefully folks that are listening can go and enable their systems right now with Azure Arc.
Yes, absolutely. So if they want to learn more, they can go to aka.ms/AAC for the Azure Architecture Center. And if they want to learn more about our hybrid solutions, just go to azure.com/hybrid.
All right. I'm learning all about Azure Arc today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.